Welcome to the Metal Forge.
I am Mark, your host. Tonight I'm going to be pounding out the best in mobile metal for you guys. And if you want to hear something, all you got to do is email me, mark@whqfm.com. All right, how is everybody tonight? I am Mark, and I am your host of the Metal Forge. Tonight, we've got a pretty cool show for you. I'm going to be playing some Abominate, some Hookers, White Knight. I've also got Dave in the studio from Gubbey Records, and he's going to be talking about some of their releases and all of their bands. So, for those who are out there who are, real metal fans, here's a band called Abominate and their cover of Battery.
We'll be right back.
All right. I absolutely love that song, and that was Across the Earth by White Knight. Before that, we had 12 Gauge Reaction by Hookers, and of course, Abominant covering The Battery from Metallica, of course. And like I said, I have Dave in the studio with Gubbey Records. How are you doing today, Dave?
Very well. Pleasure to be here. Pleasure to be here.
Absolutely. And thank you for coming out and everything, and thank you, everybody, for listening. So tell me about Gubbey Records. How did you start?
I think we started pretty much out of the need to release music. I was playing music, and I needed a place to release it. And then we just basically grew from there.
So you've released your own band independently.
Yes.
And then have moved to releasing other bands locally as well.
Yeah.
Local or regional? Is it all Louisville?
Pretty much all Louisville. We've released two bands from Chicago.
Awesome.
But other than that, yeah, we just stick with Louisville music because there's quite a bit of it here.
Absolutely, there is. And, yeah, we've got a ton of it.
Hundreds.
That we play, like 35,000 songs and stuff like that is what I think that Gary had said.
That's amazing.
And it's all local, everything. So what is your most current release?
Our most current release, I'm trying to think what was the last thing we put out. The one we have coming up, the most current one we have coming up is actually going to be released on a Game Boy cartridge.
No, I think I saw something on Facebook about that.
Yeah.
Is it,
it's a band called Belushi Speedball.
Right, mm-hmm. Right. And, we played some of them earlier, Power Speedball.
Yes.
Derek Wade Manley on the Afternoon Drive played that.
Cool.
And I was just like, this is so awesome. And it is. It's total good stuff. Because I believe, I think they're playing this weekend at Spinelli's downtown.
Ah, yes, they are this weekend.
Saturday night.
I
believe that started at 6, and it's Girl Woods, Belushi Speedball, and a few others.
Yeah.
So got the show plug out there for you guys.
Should be pretty awesome.
So when did Gubbey Records begin?
Gubbey Records began in 1994, so quite a few years ago.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So your 25th anniversary this
year.
Yeah,
you know, I never even really thought about it.
That's actually pretty cool. I mean,
yeah.
Are you going to put out like a... I know you do compilations.
Yes.
A Head Cleaner that's a cassette-only release. Is that correct?
Yeah, it's cassette, and then there's like an additional digital download that comes with it. So
awesome.
Anything that couldn't fit on the cassettes basically went onto the digital downloads. Now, we did stop doing Head Cleaner just for your information. It just became it was a very large project. Our last one had 188 local bands on it.
Right, and that was a few years ago.
Yes.
It was like 2014 or 15, something like that?
2015.
Okay.
And we are planning some more compilation releases in the future here shortly, but nothing to the extent of 188 bands. It was a great time. It was a good to do, but we really only have so much time in the day, so that's we're going to cut it back to charity compilations.
Absolutely. I was part of one of those a long time ago. It was a Crusade for Children charity CD release and everything. So
very cool.
I totally know what you mean with that, and that's actually a really good idea, and you know, it puts things back out into the community.
Yeah.
So you brought me some cool stuff today. I'm being unprofessional and reaching for it behind me. The people who are watching on Facebook Live can see that. You brought me a couple of singles. Is that correct?
Yeah, there's some singles. There's a full length and a 7-inch in there.
Awesome. And the 7-inch is Satellite Twin, Will Make Fires, and it's a split with Mutt's Better Believe It.
Yes.
That's pretty cool, and I told you when you brought it to me I was going to buy it the other day, so I was kind of glad that I didn't.
Awesome.
Because I feel really good about getting it.
Cool.
And I love the local vinyl stuff, as you and I have spoke with before.
Oh, sure.
So I want to feature one of your bands right now.
Oh, that'd be great.
Satellite Twin with the song Mechanical Heart.
Ah, beautiful.
Oh, and that's Satellite Twin with Mechanical Hearts. Speaking with Dave still, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Doing great. Any other, you know, you've been out, you've had the label for about 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
You've put out quite a few compilations. You've put out quite a few Louisville bands. Do you have a favorite release that you've ever put out? Not to chuck
they're
in.
They're all my favorites,
they're
Mark.
They're all your baby.
All my babies, yeah. You know, there's just...
No, I didn't mean to ask to, yeah, if you, to pick a favorite. Like,
there's so many good bands. Like, I'd hate to pick a favorite.
Really. Absolutely. So, what is your next release?
My next release is the Belushi Speedball.
Right.
That we just discussed. And then we also just sent to the presses a few days ago a newer band from Louisville called the Archaeas. They're a punk band, and kind of what we're trying to do this year is kind of get some of the younger acts to maybe, you know, because there's this newer group of Louisville musicians that are coming up, like, you know, Wombo, Girlwood, all these
tycoons of teen,
you know, and Ron and all these Zerg Rush. All these bands that are coming up, and we're just trying to grab a few of them and trying to get them out. So the Archaeas is coming up after that. They got an EP, 5-song EP, that's going to be on cassette.
Awesome.
That as soon as it gets in our hands, we'll be getting it out.
Absolutely. So explain to me the idea behind the Belushi Speedball 8-bit release on a Game Boy cartridge.
Well, I mean, the idea is, I guess, is how completely ridiculous is it, first and foremost, that something can be put on Game Boy and distributed to the mass markets. It will also be on CD and digital download as well. But
absolutely. It's like a keepsake.
It's like a keepsake. It's a promotional tool, more or less, from and you know, Vinny had the idea from Belushi Speedball, had the idea, and I guess he was able to actually get it to work. And
so it will actually play.
It does function, yes, and they will be selling them there. They're on Game Boy and Game Boy Advanced.
Yeah, so pre-order it now, by the way, if that's the case, because I guarantee no one else is doing that. And, it's kind of like, what were those? They were about 15 years ago. They were like a little talk box type release that only played the album.
Yes.
And it's kind of like that, you know?
Yeah,
it's
very
like,
similar.
But that's pretty cool. I mean, you don't see people doing releases like that.
Yes.
And again, you expressed to me before that you really have always put out cassette tape.
Yeah, we actually started our first releases were on cassette tape. We never really...
Because cassette was the thing.
Well, it was a thing in the 90s, for sure. It was still a thing, and very cheap in the 90s as well, because it was pretty accessible. As we get into this decade, well, tape's starting to get a lot more expensive because more people are using it, and the tape supply dried up over about 2 years ago.
Oh,
and
wow.
A manufacturer... finally built a tape line. So there's now a new manufacturer.
There's a
new market for it. So, yeah.
And again, you know, a lot of like home stereo consoles are still packaging cassette decks.
For sure, in
like a combo with like a record, phonograph record player, and a CD player and a tape deck.
And what we found is like a lot of our market, drives older cars, and
so they still have
they still have cassette decks. So we find that people do that, and all of our cassettes obviously come with a digital download card. So you know we're trying to stay in the new century while still trying to stay where we originally came from.
Awesome, and that you know that's pretty cool because you know anytime that I ever bought a car that had a cassette deck in it, it was a piece of trash, and the cassette deck would always eat my tapes. So
got to clean them.
Absolutely. Exactly, because head cleaner.
Yep, absolutely.
All right, I want to. Here we are with some of the promo stuff going on this week.
Be sure to tune in tonight and every night at midnight for the Blues Hour, right here on WCHQ.
It's 45 degrees.
It's 7:31.
Time for the WCHQ Concert View, a service of WCHQ 100.9 FM and Leo Weekly, Louisville's eccentric observer since 1990. Pick up your free copy at any of Leo's 500 distribution points to read smart and irreverent news, commentary, music, and arts coverage.
All right, this is your WCHQ Concert View for Thursday, January 17th. I'm Ed. Let's take a look at what's shaking and baking in the Louisville area this evening. Starting over at the Butchertown Social, Cosmic Collective is performing tonight starting at 9 o'clock. MC McIntyre is over at the Zanzibar starting tonight at 8 o'clock. The Troubadours of Divine Bliss are at Goodwood Brewing tonight starting at 8 o'clock. Mr. Clit and the Pink Cigarettes, Belushi Speedball, and El Bisante are over at the Kaiju tonight starting at 9 o'clock. Randy Steele is over at Lettersong Calligraphy Studio right down here on Story Avenue starting tonight at 7:30. Elephant Path, The Captain of the Ship, and Robert Craven are over at the Mag Bar tonight starting at 8 o'clock. Nate Tumas is over at Merle's Whiskey Kitchen tonight starting at 8 o'clock. Jet Ski Hallway is at Wick's Pizza in Middletown starting tonight at 7 o'clock. The Louisville Hot Club is at the Heller High Water Bar tonight starting at 8 o'clock. It is piano night over at Jimmy Can't Dance with Mike Hood starting tonight at 9 o'clock. George Stearman is over at Derby City Pizza Company starting tonight at 7 o'clock. Dusty Bow is live at Levy at the Riverhouse starting tonight at 7 o'clock. Over at Stevie Ray's Blues Bar, it is the world-famous Thursday Night Throwdown kicking off at 8 o'clock. John Mueller and Tim Barnes are over at Surface Noise starting tonight at 7 o'clock. Aorta present Tides of Man, Street Sense, Alucius and Refractions over at the Tiger Room starting tonight at 7 o'clock. John Baxter is at the Dundee Tavern starting tonight at 8 o'clock. And that is your WCHQ Concert View for today.
This has been your WCHQ Concert View. If you've got a gig you'd like to let us know about, head over to WCHQFM.com and hit the icon at the top of the screen that says List Your Gig.
Yeah.
Oh, right. And that was Baby Bones with Pay Us in Dimes from the album The Curse of Crystal Teeth, which was released in 2018. I've had to say that to many venue over many a year. Pay me in dimes. Because that's about all I ever made from a lot of them was about 25 cents. So
I hear that.
Was that a conscious effort for... You know, life imitating art or art imitating life?
Most likely, yeah. We don't really like to tell people what our songs are about.
So. Absolutely. So that was the band Baby Bones, and you are in that band, correct?
I am, actually, yes.
Okay. How long have you been
We've been together for about two years now.
2 years?
Yes.
Awesome.
Yeah, probably one of the most satisfying bands I've been in ever.
And that's what it's about, honestly.
Yeah.
The satisfaction of it. Mm-hmm. Is that your first release as the band? Or?
That is our first release. We're currently working on a new EP to be released later this year on vinyl. I don't think it's going to come out on Gubbey Records. I think it's going to be on another label. But yes, we are working on some stuff currently.
Awesome. Anybody in the... Here's a question for you. Anybody in the local music scene... that you can talk about that you're going to be putting something out by that's not somebody other than like Belushi Speedball or
yes.
anybody like that. Like, are you going to release the next Ulm album?
I wish.
Stuff like that.
This isn't a metal record, but we are releasing a full length from Forest and the Photons. They are a kind of sound. I mean, it's a very broad generalization, but they kind of sound like Ben Folds meets something else.
Is something else like
I can't quite put my finger on it.
Like
but
Ben Folds meets a sledgehammer.
No. But yeah, those are the three right now. And then we also have another release in the works from a band, underground type band here in Louisville that only plays out every once in a while called Bus Huss. And their album that was released years ago, but we remastered it, we're repackaging it, and it's called Expectations About Big Cities. And they're kind of a rap group, kind of something else, but Gubbey Records, we just don't just put out one style of music. We try
Absolutely.
To...
Absolutely, I have noticed that.
Encompass as many as we can.
Especially, you know, the Baby Bones album, the new bravado from Sun
Very
and Moon,
cool. yeah.
which I absolutely love that album.
Awesome.
They've got a, like I've said before, that I think they have a real like Sabbath feel to them.
Absolutely.
Other than that, you know, you all did the Satellite Twin, mm-hmm. Mechanical Hearts EP, so on and so forth. So how can people get more info on Gubbey Records? Like, do you have an email? Do you have a website?
Yeah, we have a website. We also have Facebook and Instagram and all the social medias. But our website is www.gubbeyrecords.com. It's G-U-B-B-E-Y records.com.
And it's got a picture of a squirrel on it?
Absolutely, yes.
Which is awesome. Now, do you accept submissions?
We accept... we're one of the few labels that still accepts brought by an attorney. Yeah, submission. So yeah, if you'd like to, our on there is our PO box. Just send your stuff directly to our PO box. I promise we will listen to it. It will get listened to. It does take a little time. We're a very small staff. It's just myself and you know, a few other friends that help out with it from time to time. But we will listen to it, and you know, depending on our budget and depending on, you know, maybe if, you know, sometimes bands like to work with us as well as far as budgetary concerned. You know, it, you know, may or may not be possible, but you know, send it out. Send it anyways. We're gonna give it a listen. I promise.
Absolutely. And I'm assuming that's how New Bravado done it as well. You know, they said, hey,
good friend, just through friends and stuff like that, you know.
Well, how about we play a song from them right now? And
awesome.
I played this a few weeks ago because, like I said, I love the tune. It's real Sabbathy. It's a song called Translucent Dreams.
Cool.
We'll be right back.
that was Translucent Dreams by New Bravado from the Sun and Moon album back in 2015. That's a long time ago at this point.
It seems like it.
4 years ago? Shoot. Whew. Oh, my gosh. So I'm sitting in here with Dave from Gubbey Records. We've talked about the 8-bit release from, the Game Boy release from Belushi Speedball. Is it going to be like a Game Boy Color? Or straight up original Game Boy, like
no,
green,
it is straight up
screen.
Original. It is original Game Boy.
That's awesome to me, and I'm just like I'm fascinated by that to see like is there like a digital product like a production on the screen when the music is playing. Like,
there
is
going to
be like Mega Man running through something.
I wish. I don't think that we got that far with it.
Oh, wow.
But there is a video you can watch online to see that it actually does work.
That's so cool. I mean, again, it's a marketing thing.
Absolutely.
And you know, because I'm of the age where, you know, I remember when the first Game Boy was released.
Me too.
And it's interesting because it was released for Japanese businessmen to play on the airplane for between, you know, like flights and stuff like that, which is, and now here we are 30 years later and there's a Louisville, Kentucky band called Belushi Speedball. Wonder where we got the name for one. Awesome. Who's putting out an album that's going to be on that. And that's pretty cool.
That's pretty rad. Yeah.
So is there an album release set for that?
There is. It's on April 20th.
Which would be like a Monday, I think. Is that right? Or Sunday?
I have no idea, man.
Look at your calendars. Find April 20th. And it's going to be Belushi Speedballs.
Kaiju.
At Kaiju, which is on Oak Street. And is there a particular venue that you like to play?
Man, I really do love Kaiju. It is a very, very well-run venue.
I haven't played there since it has become Kaiju.
Yeah.
I remember the old place.
Mm-hmm. Lisa's. Yeah.
Yeah, shout out to Lisa for that if she listens. But yeah, and that was a pretty cool place to play. You know.
Yep.
It's kind of Mag Bar like for me. It's like
for sure.
You know, tiny intimate venue. So
yeah.
So yeah.
There's tons of great venues in Louisville. I mean, Z Bar is a great room. Odeon, the new Odeon.
Right, over here on Story Avenue?
Yeah, over here on Story. And, I mean, if I'm not mentioning the venue, it doesn't mean it's not good. I just, those
right,
are like the
right.
three
and
that
that's
I can
not,
think
that's
of.
That's not what I was leading to.
Yeah, no, no,
and,
I
And
I
if anybody needs to know, Odeon used to be the Butchertown Pub back in the day.
The one place when I was a kid that I always wanted to go, but I couldn't because I was too young.
Oh, wow. See, and I always loved the Thunderdome.
Oh, and the Thunderdome was great too.
Yes,
saw many good bands there.
The first band I ever saw live that was like a real band and not like a friend's band was at Thunderdome.
Oh wow!
I was 12, and it was Social Distortion.
Oh wow! Cool.
Won tickets off the radio, actually.
That's awesome.
So, pretty good stuff, you know. So we've been jamming out to some stuff here. We've jammed out to Baby Bones, New Bravado. You know, stuff that you've put out.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you have, like, an overall goal as, like, when we came into 2019, you know, 17 days ago, did you have, like, okay, this is what I'm going to do this year. This is what I would like to do this year.
Yeah. Again, like, I want to put out some of the younger bands, some of the bands that, like, maybe I'm not, you know, best friends with these guys, you know, because my generation is my generation, and I want to reach out to the younger generation. And the big thing about my record label is I want people to feel included. I want to be as inclusive as I possibly can. I don't want to just grab the headlining act, which would be easy. You could just say, hey, I want to put out your vinyl and just grab that high act band. I want to grab bands that maybe people haven't heard of, or maybe, you know, we're kind of hiding under a rock somewhere. And that's really always been my intention. You know,
awareness.
Yeah. And at times I've not felt as included, in the music scene at times. And I think the idea of this label was to like, try to, you know, that was my response, to make people feel included. So that's really my overall goal, is to always try to grab something from a different genre or a different group of people that I don't know. You know, maybe I don't know them, but we're going to get to know each other.
Absolutely. Yeah. Have you put out any country artists?
I have on some of the Head Cleaner stuff.
But not exclusive.
You know, there's a great little country band called the Winger Brothers that just recently put something out. But I haven't, and I'm a huge bluegrass fan, so I could always see myself doing that at some point.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That would be pretty cool because, again, you know, just like here at WCHQ, you know, we mm-hmm. play everybody. We play local rock, metal, country, bluegrass, folk, all singer-songwriter type stuff.
Awesome.
So,
yeah.
And just, you know, check out anybody else's show, Zach at the Midnight Oil, mm-hmm. Derek Wade Manley, you know, doing afternoon driver, Lunch Break Live with Ed. Mm-hmm. He plays a ton of people on there. All of them do, actually.
That's great.
And, you know, it's all about building awareness to your city and your city's music.
Mm-hmm.
So if you could release any album that, if you heard an album, say, for example, the Black Album, mm-hmm. saying, any mainstream or non-mainstream music, have you ever heard an album and say, damn, I wish I released that?
Yeah, it would probably be Rodan's Rusty.
Right. Awesome. So any particular reason why? Is because it's a perfect album for you?
To me, it's a perfect album. You know, it's from start to finish, from the first note to the very last note, it's a perfect record.
It's one thing that you can listen to
constantly.
And
it's my Desert Island album.
Oh, wow. So that's awesome. And, you know, I wish I had that. It would probably, if I were to have one, it would probably be something, you know, like, probably Overkill by Motorhead.
Sweet. That's a great record, too.
I can listen to it constantly.
For sure.
And it's just so
yep.
right on it. But let's play another song here before we leave tonight. This is a song that, you know, I've really liked a lot. It's by a band called Rifle. I had them on the show a couple weeks ago. And it's a song called Let's Have a Riot.
Cool.
They've outlawed all the options and left us with no choice. A riot is the language of those who have no voice. You can't follow all this rage and try to start it. Can't put the whole world in a cage and just ignore it. We have reached critical mass. Take torches to the tower, trap them in their dens. It's time for the golden child to answer for his sins. You can't bottle all this rage and try to store it. Can't put the whole world in a cage and just ignore it. We have reached critical. Let's have a riot. Hello.
this is Maddie Driscoll, and you're listening to WCHQ-FM. Thanks for tuning in. Stay with us for more great music.
Thank you, Maddie. wow, had a little bit of snafu there at the beginning of Let's Have a Riot. Leaving the mics on, cutting the station feed. Oh, my gosh. It's like Howard Stern, what can go wrong will go wrong. Like, I'm lucky I didn't burn anything down.
It's just radio, Mark.
It is. Still get nervous. It's the fourth show in. I mean, come on.
Yep.
So, okay, Dave with Gubbey Records. GubbeyRecords.com. I think mine says .net. GubbeyRecords.anything. It'll come up.
Yeah, it should come up.
Find it on Facebook. On MySpace.
Yep, MySpace. That's our big push. We go that to MySpace.
You know, the Overload page has like 12 people.
Beautiful.
And we just hit that yesterday. No.
Nice.
So, you want to give any shout-out to anybody?
No, man. I just want to thank you for having me tonight, and congratulations on the new show here.
Thank you, and thank you for coming. And
great station.
You know, congratulations on all your releases and stuff that you do. Like I said, I go up to, you know, usually where I find your releases at is just up the street here on Frankfort Avenue at Guest Room Records.
Cool.
So I go there a lot. I pick up a lot of cool stuff up there, and
sweet.
Hey, you know. Why not, right?
Yeah, why not?
So, next week, we have in studio Jeff Gaither, local artist, legendary.
Legendary,
local artist. He's done artwork for Guns N' Roses, G.G. Allin, so the Murder Junkies. That's who I was trying to say.
There you go.
Murder Junkies, The Accused, My Own Victim locally, Stonecutters locally, yeah. I believe. Possibly some Overload eventually. Had a ton of awareness to it. So check out next week. And tonight I'm going to leave you here with a track that you probably wouldn't expect. It's a song called Die Born by Days of the New. Thank you all. Good night.
Night.
Said you gotta keep me warm. You will run from my eyes. They stare you down and make you burn. I am the king of the jungle. I'm the little dog. Say the king of the jungle makes me humble. Yeah. I will not die. This is not-